Hey guys, let me show you how to properly use a pressure sterilizer to make plant tissue culture media. Here are the two types of sterilizers I use in the lab. However, the method I'm going to show you applies to all styles pressure cookers and to newer like electric-like pressure cooker like Instant Pots. So the big one is an All-American. It is stirring 9 liters. And it's a very popular sterilizer for tissue culture and for mushrooms. The small one is made by Athena. It is 8 liters and it's also a very heavy duty sterilizer. The size difference makes the Athena a much faster sterilizer. On average, the Athena only takes under an hour to do a full cycle, and the All American takes about 2 hours. And the reason is because obviously the size difference and the amount of water they require. So the Athena only requires less than 1 liter of water to work. So you see, I fill the water all the way to the bottom tray. And for the All American, I do the same thing. It has the bottom tray you see right there, and it also has the marking right on the side. So I need to fill all the water all the way to that mark. And for that, I'm using the rest of the gallon that I use here previously to fill the Athena's sterilizer. So it takes this full gallon and an extra one. So it just takes just under 2 gallons of water to fill the All American. That makes this All American much slower, because it takes a while to heat all of that water and to build pressure. So in the lab, I use the Athena's sterilizer for most of my work, except for when I'm doing like very big loads. So to fill it up, I'm using this as for example. I'm using these test tubes. They are empty. I'm making my media in the in a media bottle, and make sure when I put the media in, make sure to have the cap to be loose. I'm also adding some biocouplers, so just to show you how to sterilize them. One is empty and the other one has the media on it. And if your sterilizer is not tall enough to fit the biocouplers assemble, you can have them separate. So you can add the caps on it and add the media to one. And also for the coupler, you can use aluminum foil to wrap the biocoupler. Now I'm closing the sterilizer, so using all the knobs. And to close it, you want to do it like a car wheel, where you don't go in order. You want to do on opposite ends to make sure that it has evenly closed the lid. For the Athenas, it also has the inner liner. However, the Athena does not have a hose to go all the way down. And for that reason, it cannot leave an air packet of air inside of the sterilizer. So I don't use the inner liner. So I just take that out and I use the bottom tray. Actually, the bottom tray is very nice because it's pretty much almost flat. It does have a few holes, but they are not that big. So I can see like the test tubes that I'm doing right now very nicely in there. So the whole rack. Then I put in my media in there and a biocoupler. So the 8-ounce biocoupler fits in the Athena sterilizer, which is great. However, you want to use the 16 ounces, you will have to disassemble. Close the lid by tightening the knob. However, make sure it's not too tight. And after that, keep the valve open because you want to bleed all the air. That is the reason why I removed the inner liner from the All American, because it doesn't have the inner tube that goes all the way to the bottom tray. If your pressure cooker has a rocker like the old style pressure cookers, you can leave it on, as it does a pretty good job bleeding all the air. So to turn on the All American, turn on the switch, and it has this knob that it controls the power of the pressure cooker. And it also has a timer. However, the timer is mechanical, it's not connected to anything, so it is very old style. For the Athena, it has a very simple operation. You just press a button and it starts to work. After 15 minutes, you start seeing a steam coming out of the Athena's sterilizer. So now you can close the valve and let the Athena sterilizer do its cycle automatically. So it's going to run the 25 minutes cycle, and it's going to turn off by itself. Let the pressure come down to zero before opening the sterilizer. After you open it, you want to leave everything there for about 5 minutes to make sure everything has cooled down. in the at the same time, the All American is just now starting to bleed all the air, and now I'm closing the valve. And after 5 minutes, I can take the everything, all the contents on the test tubes and the media that I made from the Athena out. After about an hour later, the All American has run the cycle. So I run it for 15 minutes, 125 degrees Celsius. So I'm opening the lid, and again, I'm going to let it cool down before I take any of the contents
out. Both sterilizers has its pros and cons. The Athena is fast and it's aromatic, however, it's quite small.
The All American is big, but it's very slow and it's not aromatic. You have to make sure to pay attention on the pressure of the sterilizers to make sure you set your timer, otherwise you can overcook your tissue culture media. However, I do have a second All American sterilizer that I turned into a Wi-Fi controller, fully automated sterilizer that is absolutely amazing. Leave a like and let me know down in the comments if you want me to make a video on how to make the conversion. Now, this is a video on how to use the sterilizers. However, it's also important for me to show you how to pour the media, because this is one of the biggest mistakes I see beginners do, and it's not shaking the media bottle after each pour. You are using it charcoal in the medium. The charcoal is not going to dissolve like agar. So it's going to settle on the bottom. So you're going to end up with some tubes or some flasks with more charcoal than other ones. I hope this video has gave you a better understanding on how to sterilize the tissue culture media. The bigger takes is to let all the air bleed out of the sterilizers. Set your timers to sterilize for only 15 to 25 minutes. And also shake your media between each pour so you have an even consistency. Thanks for watching the video. If you are enjoying these tissue culture videos, make sure to follow us on social media for more informative content. And if you are interested on conducting your own tissue culture experiments, make sure to check us out at plantsafetechnology.com for all the products you need to get started. Use code FP10 for 10% off on your first purchase.